Welcome you all. I'm Srinath, Faculty of Mechanical Engineering Department, Canara Engineering College, Bangalore. In this session, I will explain about the flow past on immersed bodies. Hello. On today's class, I will explain about flow past immersed bodies. So this is lecture number one. You see these images. Now one stationary body is held here and the flow of fluid is flowing over that body. So we can see the disturbance occurs at the behind that object. So now in front of the object the fluid is flowing at a streamline. And at the back side of the object, we can observe some disturbance. So one more image is here. Here also we can see the observe the changes in the direction of the fluid flow or the path taken by the fluid flow. Okay, these are one more image is here. So here is the fluid is flowing over a body. So we can see some disturbance occurs or the different path is taken by that fluid direction. So when a fluid is flowing over a stationary body, a force is exerted by the fluid on the body. Or similarly, when a body is moving in a stationary fluid, a force is exerted by the fluid on the body. In case both body and fluid both are moving at different velocities, a force is exerted by the fluid on the body. The examples, the fluid is flowing over a stationary bodies or bodies moving in stationary fluids are, the one is flow of air over buildings. Next, here we can see the image of what the flow of air over that buildings. The building is there. And we can see the disturbance on that fluid flow direction. Here. And there is a very multi-store floor building is here. We can see in front of the building the fluid is flowing at parallel lines, that is called a streamlined one, and the back side of the buildings we can observe some disturbance, that is called as a wake formation, or the suction region is created on back side of the buildings. Here you can clearly identify, you can see for the wake formation or the high suction regions are formed on back side of the multi-store buildings. The next one more example for that one, same the flow of water over bridges. So here we can see the some for the wake formation regions at the in a nearby the surface of their pillars. Here also we can observe or some disturbance there. Then the flow of air or water through the automobiles. See, The low pressure region is formed at the back side of the car. The same thing will happen while the aeroplane is flying at very high altitude regions. The formation of wakes on the truss, back side of the truss. So these are some examples of the. That means the pressure for or the forces acting on that moving body by the flowing fluid. The next you can see the ship and the force exerted by a flowing fluid on a stationary body, here the body is considered stationary, then the fluid is flowing over that body. The fluid is flowing at the velocity, there is a uniform velocity u as shown in figure here. Here one stationary body is held against the direction of the fluid flow. Okay, is moving at a uniform velocity at u. So now the fluid will exert a force on stationary body. The total force denoted by Fr exerted by the fluid on the body is perpendicular to the surface of the body. We can see that the total force acting on the body is exactly what the perpendicular to the body. So that is denoted by Fr here. Thus the total surface is inclined to the direction of the motion. The total force can be resolved into two components, the one in the direction of the motion, the another perpendicular direction of the motion. So here the fluid is flowing at the velocity of u. So then the total force is given by in the direction perpendicular to the body. And this total force is resolved in two different directions. There are the two different components, that is one in the direction of the fluid flow, another one in the direction, the perpendicular to the direction of the motion, the direction of the fluid flow. That one, the first one is called as a drag. The component of the total force Fr in the direction of the motion is called drag. The first component of the total force, that is a drag. The drag is considered in the direction of the fluid flow. So that component is denoted by Fd. Thus the drag is the force exerted by the fluid in the direction of the motion. So one more component that is taken into perpendicular to the direction of the fluid flow. So that is called as lift. The component of the total force Fr in the direction perpendicular to the direction of the motion is known as lift. It is denoted by Fl. Thus, lift force is force exerted by the fluid in the direction perpendicular to the direction of the motion. Lift force occurs only when the axis of the body is inclined to the direction of the fluid flow. The lift will occur only in case the body is inclined at an angle to the direction of the fluid flow. In case the body is placed parallel to the axis of the fluid flow, at that time the lift force is zero. So that means there is no lift force. That means there is no chances of lifting the body from its axis. There is no lift force here. So then that in that case only drag force acts. The drag and lift for a body moving in the fluid of density rho, then at uniform velocity of u, then it is calculated mathematically by using the expressions. So this is Fd is equals to Cd into area into rho u square by 2. So that is called as drag force. So here D represents, that is the drag force. So Cd is equals to coefficient of drag. Then A is equals to area of the stationary body. Rho is equals to density of the fluid. flowing through that surface, then u is equals to given by velocity of the fluid flow. And similarly, for lift force, the FL is equals to CL into area into rho u square by 2. Here CL is equals to coefficient of lift. A is equals to area of the body perpendicular to the direction of the flow, and this is the largest projected area of the immersed body. Thus, the total force or the resultant force on the body is given by FR is equals to square root of drag force square plus lift force square. That is it. That is equals to square root of FD square plus FL square. So these are the two expressions are used in order to find out the drag force as well as lift force when the fluid is flowing over a stationary body. Next term is used in that fluid flow over a body, that is a streamlined body. The body whose surface is coincides with the streamlines when placed in a flow is called a streamlined body. See here, the body is placed parallel to the direction of the fluid flow here. We can see the flow of fluid over that stationary body. See here, the wave formation at the backside or the trailing edge of the body is very very small. For that reason, see here the minimum drag force can be created at the back side of the body or the trailing edge of the body. The flow separation takes place only at the trailing edge or the rearmost part of the body. The wave formation zone behind the streamlined body is very small. That means the smooth flow of this fluid flow occurs through this streamlined body here. Therefore, that reason the pressure drag will also very small in this streamlined body. That means in this case, the boundary layer separation is minimum when compared to the wave formation. The body may be streamlined at low velocities but may not be so at higher velocity. That means we can see it is streamlined only at the low velocity, but it cannot possible to retain that the smooth flow of fluid at higher velocities. When placed in perpendicular position in fluid, but may not be so when placed in another position. Such streamlined shapes are used for the wings of the aeroplane, blades of the marine propeller, rotary axial flow machines. So this diagram shows what the streamlined body. See here, the air strikes to the wings of the aeroplane, and we can see what the pressure difference at the wings of this one, at the top surface as well as the bottom surface of the wing. And the air is moving at the different velocities at top layer as well as the bottom layer of the wing. So this is one example for the streamlined body. So this one is a turbine, that is the blades of marine propeller. Next one is a bluff body, the body whose surface does not coincide with the streamlines, so when it is placed in the flow. Actually, in this one, the body is almost placed exactly perpendicular to the direction of the fluid flow. In such things are called as now bluff body. See this diagram. So one body is exactly placed at certain height, so perpendicular to the direction of the slope. See here, for boundary separation occurs over this body, and back side or the trailing side of the body creates the maximum suction occurs that creates for some the wake formation. So these are the some images that shows the difference between the streamline body as well as a bluff body. So there is a extensive boundary layer separation with a wake with a large scale eddy. There is a maximum disturbance we can observe in such the bluff type of the bodies. So due to large wake formation, the resulting pressure drag is very large as compared to the drag due to the friction on the body. So this is information related to the bluff body as well as the streamline body. In this class, we discussed about the flow of fluid over a body. In this case, we can see the forces acting on that body. So that is a resultant force, and there is also that is formed because of the lift force as well as drag force. So later we discussed about the streamlined body as well as a bluff body. Thank you.